मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दि नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दि नेटवर्क थियरम इज पार्ट टू. हियर आई विल बी डिस्क्राइबिंग यू अबउट दि अनदर टू थियरम्स, दट इज नॉर्टन्स थियरम एंड मैक्सिमम पवर ट्रांसफर थियरम. दि पार्ट वन वी हैव सीन दि सूपर पोजिशन थियरम एंड दि थेवेनिन्स थियरम. होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दि कंप्लीट पार्ट ऑफ दि थेवेनिन्स थियरम. सिंस नेटवर्क थियरम, इन दि नेटवर्क थियरम नॉर्टन थियरम इज दि कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ दि थेवेनिन्स थियरम. So here, instead of in the Thevenin's theorem, you have the voltage and the resistance in the series. But you all know already that if you have voltage source, you can connect the internal resistance in series. But if we have the current source, you have to connect the internal resistance in parallel. But the concept and the finding out the parameters and everything is same as that of the Thevenin's theorem. Here, instead of V Thevenin, we'll be using I Norton. And instead of R Thevenin, you will be using R Norton, that is resistance according to Norton's theorem and current according to the Norton's theorem. So for a linear network, we have to collect the current sources and we have to find out the IN, and we have to collect the resistance sources and the resistance part, and we have to find out the R Norton's. First, we'll see how we need to find out the I Norton. Remove that portion of the network across which the Norton equivalent circuit is found is the first step, and second step is mark the terminals, and third part we have to find out the R Norton, that is resistance, equivalent resistance, which is called as Norton resistance, and from that we have to find out the I Norton. Since we all know that R Thevenin is equal to R, and that is Thevenin resistance is equal to that of the Norton resistance. How we have found out the Thevenin resistance value? In the same case, we have to find out the Norton resistance value. For IN, how we need to find out the IN is, first we have to return all sources to this original position, and if it is the same current, that would be measured by an ammeter. What is the current flowing through the circuit is nothing but your IN. Next, finally, we have to conclude it with I Norton and the R Norton part. So you have the example problem here. See, in this resistance we have 25 ohm voltage, 3 amps, 20 ohms, 5 ohms resistances, and we have another 4 ohms. First, we are making it as a open circuit as in the case of Thevenin circuit, and we are going to convert all the voltage source into the current source. See, 5 volt and 5 ohm is already there. So now we have to convert that into current source. So 25 divided by 5 is 5 amps. 25 is your voltage, 5 is your resistance. 25 divided by R is V by R is equal to I. So 5 amps is nothing but your current source here. So next, what is the second step is, you have to make it as a parallel source and parallel resistance. In that case, you are going to form a simplified circuit with one current source and one resistance, 8 amps and the 4 ohms, and once again a load resistance 4 ohms is connected. Now you can able to convert that as a original source, which is your voltage source. If you need to convert that as a original source, you can able to multiply I into R, that is equal to V. I is 8 amps, R is 4, so 8, 4, so 32, and once again, now it is converted into source. The remaining resistance are 4 plus 4, it is connected in series, so 4 plus 4 is 8. This is your original circuit, that is your Thevenin equivalent circuit. The above is Norton circuit and below is Thevenin, so you can able to visualize it. It is a parallel combination. If you need to view a circuit in a Norton form, then you have current and the voltage, so that is resistance. If you need to view the same circuit into a Thevenin's form, then you have a voltage source and the resistance. So this is your final Thevenin circuit, or that is a final Norton circuit consisting of one current source and one resistance. So current source is 4 amps, resistance is 8 amps. Next is maximum power transfer theorem for the DC network. Maximum power transfer theorem states that in a DC network, maximum power is transferred to the load when the load resistance is equal to that of the Thevenin's resistance. So you can able to see a circuit consisting of a voltage source, a resistance and RL. Voltage source is V Thevenin, RTH is your Thevenin resistance, RL is your load resistance. What is the concept of this maximum power transfer theorem is, a maximum power from the V will be transferred to RL if your R Thevenin resistance and RL resistance is common. If both resistance values common, then it is absolutely confirmed that the maximum power will be transferred to the load. So this is your equation to find out R Thevenin is equal to RL. So first we are taking a load power, PL is your power of the load, which is given as the equation, and we are going to minimize this equation and we are finding it as R Thevenin is equal to RL. That is simplifying the equation and we are finding it as conformly R Thevenin is equal to RL. That is, if your Thevenin resistance and load resistance are same, it is confirmed that your maximum power will be transferred to the load. So what are all the equations we are going to frame from this is, what is the power delivered to the load? So power delivered to the load is nothing but normally power equation is V square by R. That V is VL and R is RL. So VL divided by RL is equal to PL. So this is what D by DRL into PL is equal to 0. So maximum power for the load is V Thevenin the whole square RL divided by R Thevenin plus RL. So we all know that R Thevenin is equal to RL. So we are going to convert that for maximum power transfer theorem. The condition is R Thevenin is equal to RL. So you are going to convert all the RL value into R Thevenin. So in that case, we will be getting V Thevenin by 4 RTH. So P, total power consumed by R Thevenin is equal to I square RL into RL. IL is nothing but V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin plus RL. If R Thevenin is equal to RL, then the value will be is equal to 100. So for efficient, normally if you don't consider R Thevenin RL, your efficiency will be 50%. But if you consider R Thevenin is equal to RL, then efficiency will be 100%. So to attain this efficiency, we are going for the maximum power transfer theorem. See here, a circuit is given. The first step in the circuit is you are going to remove the RL, that is 5 ohm resistance is removed, and next you have to find out V Thevenin from the first part of the circuit and R Thevenin from the total equivalent resistances. We have 3 resistance, no? So you are going to apply KVL for the first mesh. Since we have only one mesh, you are going to apply KVL for the first mesh and you are going to find out I value, that is I 2 amps. Next, KVL for the second mesh and you are going to find out V Thevenin by substituting I is equal to 2 amps. And second step 2, next you have to calculate the R Thevenin. See, here you have only 3 resistance, 2 ohms, 4 ohms and 3 ohms. So you can able to see 3 ohm and 4 ohm are series resistance. Now you just form a value, 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. So finally R Thevenin will be equal to 2 into 7 by 2 plus 7. 2 into 7 is 14, 2 plus 7 is 9, 9 by 4. So you can able to find out the R value. So this is your V Thevenin value, you know already it is 3 and R value is equal to 4.33 ohm. So from this you can able to say that R Thevenin is equal to RL. So formula for power maximum power transfer theorem is equal to V Thevenin by 4 R Thevenin. So in that case you are going to substitute RL values, R Thevenin itself. So 4 into 4.33. Finally, maximum power transferred is 50% of power is transferred if this theorem is applied. Thank you.